visiting professor at San Maria Sison. So as a special coordinator of the International League of People's Struggle for Latin America, or ILPS, I'd like to interview you as the chairperson of the International Coordinating Committee of ILPS and as the outstanding leader of the Philippine National Liberation Movement, no less than the founding chairperson of the Communist Party of the Philippines. Thank you so much for being interviewed. So Cuba and the Philippines belong to two different continents and are thousands of miles away from each other. But they say that there's a certain closeness between the Cuban and Filipino peoples. Can you describe that to us, please?
There is a strong sense of solidarity and empathy between the Filipino and Cuban peoples because they have suffered under Spanish colonialism and U.S. imperialism and struggled against these two foreign powers. They admire each other's revolutionary struggles and victories. The Filipino people are inspired by the great victory of the Cuban people in liberating themselves from U.S. imperialism and the local reactionary classes of big compradores and landlords represented by the corrupt Batista regime. I presume that there are a considerable number of Cubans with Filipino ancestry because many Filipinos were brought in to work in the tobacco industry, the tabacaleros. There were so many Filipinos that the Pinar del Rio province in Cuba was formerly called Nueva Filipinas in the 18th century. The Cubans called them Chinos de Manila. Currently, the closeness of the Filipino and Cuban peoples is manifested by the Philippine-Cuban Friendship Association in the Philippines. From year to year, there are solidarity activities in the Philippines and cultural exchanges between Cuba and the Philippines. Since the struggle of the Filipino people intensified against Marcos' dictatorship in the first half of the 1980s, the Cuban embassy has shown sympathy and support for Bayan and other organizations in the National Democratic Movement of the Filipino people.
It can be said that the historical experiences and destinies of Cuba and the Philippines are intertwined. Can you tell us more about this?
Spanish colonialism imposed in the Philippines and Cuba similar patterns of theocratic rule, feudal economy, and medieval culture. It used the encomienda system, slavery, and forced labor, and feudal tributes to lay the foundation of feudalism in both countries. Both the Cuban and the Filipino people were able to liberate themselves from Spanish colonial rule. But the U.S. intervened. As a rising modern imperialist power, the U.S. defeated Spanish colonialism in the American-Spanish War of 1898 and grabbed Cuba, Puerto Rico, and the Philippines to impose U.S. colonial rule under the Paris Treaty of December 1898. Since then, the Filipino and Cuban peoples have been bound by a common desire to fight and defeat U.S. imperialism and its puppets. The Filipino people can learn a lot from the Cuban people in liberating themselves from U.S. domination and maintaining their national independence and social system.
In your personal experience, how did the Cuban experience and the Cuban Revolution led by Fidel Castro first attract your interest and attention, and how did this significantly grow?
While Fidel Castro and the Cuban revolutionaries were still in the Sierra Maestra, their revolutionary struggle caught the attention of the world and, of course, the student organization to which I belonged in the University of the Philippines. Our organization was engaged in forming study circles for the purpose of resuming the unfinished Philippine Revolution for national and social liberation against foreign and feudal domination. Thus, we were attracted to the revolutionary struggle of the Cuban people led by Fidel Castro, Che Guevara and other young people like us. We celebrated the victory of the Cuban Revolution in 1959. We did so with meetings and publishing articles about the Cuban Revolution in the Philippine Collegian, the student publication. We were further excited by the end of feudal ownership of the haciendas and the dramatic nationalization of the United Fruit and other U.S. enterprises. We admired and we were inspired by the revolutionary actions taken against U.S. imperialism and the local reactionaries. We were among the most enthusiastic in attending the film showings at the Cuban Embassy in Manila in 1961. The more the U.S. ranted against the Cuban Revolution, the more we supported the just cause of the Cuban Revolution. We were outraged when the Philippine authorities, under U.S. orders, closed down the Cuban Embassy.
Can you narrate and evaluate how the Cuban revolutionaries, led by Fidel Castro, fought and won the Cuban Revolution against the Batista regime? And then how did they continue on with winning the social revolution after the seizure of political power?
The attack on the Moncada barracks was an important initiative by the Cuban revolutionaries to signal the necessity and start of the armed revolution. But it was the guerrilla warfare in Sierra Madre that broke the back of the Batista regime. 5,000 troops of the regime were defeated there. We can say that the Cuban revolutionaries used the countryside to mobilize the peasants and farm workers and have the room of maneuver for building the revolutionary army. At the same time, the urban-based mass movement was growing and developing. Thus, it became possible to bring down the Batista regime with a combination of a successful rural-based guerrilla warfare and the urban-based mass uprising, which welcomed the forces of Castro to Havana. After the seizure of political power, the Cuban revolutionaries wanted to carry through the social revolution to the end. Thus, they decided to carry out a socialist revolution. For a certain period, communist cadres were trained for this purpose. The Cuban Communist Party was established as the advanced detachment of the working class to lead the Cuban people along the line of socialist revolution. Internal preparations had to be made for the seizure of U.S. enterprises. The violent reaction of the U.S. was anticipated. To augment the Cuban Revolution, the Cuban CP raised the banner of proletarian internationalism and established close relations with socialist countries, including China and the Soviet Union.
What was your reaction when the United States tried to overthrow the Cuban Revolutionary Government through the Bay of Pigs and all the assassination plots against Fidel Castro? And what did you think of the Soviet emplacement of nuclear weapons in Cuba?
It was despicable and outrageous for the U.S. government to have organized invasionary force that landed at the Bay of Pigs and to have plotted several times the assassination of Comrade Fidel Castro. We launched protest mass actions and publications against the U.S. acts of intervention and aggression against Cuba and the Cuban people. On the whole, the emplacement of Soviet nuclear missiles in Cuba helped to deter any full-scale attack on Cuba by the U.S. Even if Khrushchev withdrew the nuclear weapons, the U.S. still could not make any full-scale aggression or use nuclear weapons against Cuba because the U.S. was bound by agreement not to threaten Cuba with nuclear weapons and was strongly reminded that the U.S. military base in Turkey was also vulnerable to Soviet retaliation.
In retrospect, what do you think of the breakup of the Cuba-China relations in the 1960s and its subsequent developments?
I was immediately saddened when I first learned about it. There was an issue about rice, and subsequently a range of ideological and political issues arose. But the Filipino communists refrained from siding with the Chinese side against the Cuban side, although we sided with the Chinese Communist Party against the Soviet Party. We maintained our high respect for the Cuban Party, people, and revolution, and refrained from any pronouncements against them.
What do you think of Che Guevara?
Comrade Che Guevara was an outstanding proletarian revolutionary fighter and was a selfless revolutionary martyr. He exerted heroic efforts to promote the world proletarian revolution and advance the national liberation movements, especially in Latin America and Africa. I admire his revolutionary spirit and deeds. These inspired the Filipino revolutionaries.
What do you think of Cuban support for the African National Liberation Movement in the 1970s?
I have appreciated highly the support of the Cuban revolutionaries to the National Liberation Movements in Africa in the 1970s. The Cuban comrades acted in the spirit of proletarian internationalism by helping the African people liberate themselves from colonialism and by breaking the capability of the South African reactionary army to engage in aggression and thus causing the apartheid regime to ultimately weaken and seek a compromise with the African National Congress.
What do you think of Cuban relations with China and Russia in the current times?
Cuba can benefit from diplomatic and trade relations with China and Russia. The two latter countries can also benefit from the relations. They are formidable countries that can countervail the worst economic impositions and aggressive acts of U.S. imperialism and its NATO allies. The Shanghai Cooperation Organization and BRICS economic bloc, in which Russia and China are major partners, are counters to U.S. imperialist hegemony.
What do you like most about Cuba in terms of its socioeconomic and political policies?
I admire most the determination and militancy of the Cuban government and people in asserting, defending, and promoting national independence, and in working and aspiring for socialism. They have made great political, social, economic, and cultural achievements, despite the so many decades of economic blockades and acts of aggression unleashed by U.S. imperialism.
Are there any relations between the Philippine and Cuban revolutionary organizations?
According to their respective publications, the Communist Party of the Philippines and the National Democratic Front of the Philippines have relations with the Cuban Communist Party and other revolutionary forces of the Cuban people.
In recent years, have you been involved in any movement to support the Cuban people?
Of course. I have stood in solidarity with the Cuban people on major issues in defense of the national independence and social system. The International League of People Struggle, of which I am the chairperson, has supported the anti-imperialist and democratic positions of Cuba. I have attended meetings and spoken for the freedom of the Cuba Five. I have been therefore very happy with the complete freedom of all five. They were all released ultimately because of the broad solidarity support and the demand for their release all over the world.
Within the context of the International League of People's Struggle, or ILPS, what is most significant about the Cuban Revolution?
I have always said that the Cuban Revolution is outstanding and unique. It was a socialist revolution that arose not as a direct consequence of a world war, different from Russia, where the revolution occurred in connection with the First World War, and China and other countries where socialist revolutions emerged after World War II. If the Cuban people can make revolution only 90 miles away from the beast, Why cannot people elsewhere in the world? The Cuban Revolution is an inspiration to the people everywhere, not just Latin America or Africa. When the revolutionary will of the people and the correct line, strategy and tactics are adopted, the revolution can advance and succeed in many parts of the world.
Professor Sison, I have a series of questions regarding the current situation. So I'd like you to speak more about the normalization of relations between Cuba and the United States. Do you think that Cuba will be able to stand its ground in the negotiations with the U.S. in terms of lifting the embargo? And also, do you think that Cuba will be able to manage the entry of U.S. enterprises, their technology, their own ideas of modernization, or even subversion in more blatant language?
The normalization of diplomatic and trade relations between the U.S. and Cuba is welcome. Such relations should exist between countries, irrespective of their respective ideology or social system. I believe that Cuba can stand its ground in negotiations with the U.S. It has the principles and the revolutionary experience to uphold Cuban national independence and work out the normalization of diplomatic and trade relations. The Cuban President Raúl Castro is highly principled and competent. He enjoys the support of the Cuban people and Fidel Castro. With the revolutionary principles and with the 59 years of combating and countering U.S. aggression, embargo, electronic propaganda, and subversion, the Cuban government and people should be able to stay vigilant and adopt the policies and measures to control and direct the entry of U.S. companies, technology, and imperialist ideas of modernization, and prevent the subversion and destruction of the national independence and socialist aspirations.
Should the U.S. give up Guantanamo, and what should be done to pressure the U.S. to give it up?
Certainly, the U.S. should give up Guantanamo. The Cuban people and Cuban government should demand the dismantling of Guantanamo. The U.S. is holding Guantanamo in violation of Cuban sovereignty and territorial integrity. The people of the world should support the Cuban people in this regard. It is not too difficult for the U.S. to give up Guantanamo. The British gave up Hong Kong. The U.S. gave up Taiwan in principle under the One China policy. Under the pressure from the Filipino people, even the Philippine puppet government was able to reduce the perpetual lease agreement of 99 years plus renewal covering U.S. military bases and reservations to only 25 years in 1966. The U.S. also gave up entirely its military bases in Thailand soon after the Vietnam War.
Professor, have you ever been to Cuba? When and under what circumstances? And can you tell us more about the places you visited?
Yes, Julie and I were in Cuba in 1988. We came from Nicaragua to observe the progress of the Sandinista revolution. We met leaders of the government, trade union leaders, and many ordinary Cubans. We visited many places in and around Havana. We went as far as the vicinity of Guantanamo.
Professor, I know that you enjoy singing. Do you know any Cuban song? And would you like to sing it for us?
I can sing Guantanamera both in the Spanish original and my Tagalog translation of it. I can sing both versions now if you join me. I have a CD recording of the song. It is on my website, www.josemariasison.org.
Why do you like the song Guantanamera, that you've actually memorized it and even translated it to Filipino and put it on CD?
I like Guantanamera because the lyrics written by Cuban revolutionary patriot José Martí are beautiful in a lyrical and metaphorical way and is full of revolutionary meaning, and the rhythmic music is very lively You can dance to it. Now let us sing it.
Guantanamera, Guaira Guantanamera.
Guantanamera, Guaira Guantanamera.
Yo soy un hombre sincero, de donde crecen las palmas. Yo soy un hombre sincero, de donde crecen las palmas. Y antes de morir me quiero echar mis versos al alma. Guantanamera,
Guajira Guantanamera, Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera. Mi verso es de un verde claro y de un carmín encendido. Mi verso es de un verde claro y de un carmín encendido. Mi verso es de un ciervo herido que busca en el monte amparo. Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera, Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera. Con los pobres de la tierra quiero yo mi suerte echar. Con los pobres de la tierra quiero yo mi suerte echar. El arroyo de la sierra me complace más que el mar. Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera, Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera. Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera, Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera. Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera, Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera. Ako'y lalaking sincero sa lupa ng mga palma. Ako'y lalaking sincero sa lupa ng mga palma. Nais kong bago yumao, umawit ng tula ng diwa. Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera, Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera. Tula ko'y luntiang malinaw at pulang nag-aalap. Tula ko'y luntiang malinaw at pulang nag-aalap. Tula ko'y usang may sugat na nagkanlong sa gubat. Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera, Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera. Sa piling ng mahihirap ay nais kong makibaka. Sa piling ng mahihirap ay nais kong makibaka. Ang bukal sa kabundukan mas maginhawa kaysa dagat. Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera, Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera. Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera, Guantanamera, Guajira Guantanamera.